18 and say, you know, America, or maybe even some would say New York City. You know, Wall Street is this great end-time system that's called Babylon there. I don't hold that view. It's possible, but I don't hold that view. I think Babylon there in Revelation 17 and 18 is Babylon, the city of Babylon over in Iraq.
Did you listen to this liar? How many more liars like this man have misled the flock into believing that the most powerful and influential nation in history is not even in Scripture?
Our impulses are being redirected. We are living in an artificially induced state of consciousness that resembles sleep. Their intention to rule rests with the annihilation of consciousness. We are focused only on our own gain.
You know, it's time for the body of Christ to come together and quit playing church. You know, it's time for the body of Christ to come together and quit playing church. You know, it's time for the body of Christ to come together and quit playing church.
How foolish are the Jezebelian lying churches expecting us to be? Will the Jezebelian churches be judged for their lies? Does Jeremiah chapter 23 have anything to say about this? Is the defeated country of Iraq the Babylon, the whore of Babylon in Revelation chapter 17 and 18? Hardly. I don't care if they are even rebuilding a city there. This is stupidity. The churches are stupid. They are foolish. Iraq is not a military or even an economic power. And what about the Catholic Church? Are they Babylon, the whore of Babylon in the last days? Most think so because it seems to be an easy answer to what should not be a difficult question. It should be quite clear. The Catholic Church is not the whore of Babylon. The Catholic Church, however, did start the pagan and unrighteous religion called Christianity, which has corrupted the entire earth. So why are the Jezebelian churches covering over the truth of who the end times Babylon really is? The whore of Babylon thinks she sits as a queen. In other words, America thinks it is a Christian nation married to Emmanuel the King, and that she is not a widow. America of the Babylon does not think it is divorced from Emmanuel. America of the Babylon thinks it will not see sorrow. It will not see defeat. Yes, America of the Babylon does not think that it is under judgment, let alone will be completely destroyed.
The damage that is done is incalculable. Economically, physically, emotionally, spiritually, facts are there. The crime rates, the homeless, the drug addiction, the people who lost their businesses, on and on and on.
The world is serious about coming after you and your children. We need to come together. I ain't talking about Republicans. I'm talking about believers.
Yet America the Babylon is much worse than Sodom and Gomorrah. As said before, those who forget history are doomed to repeat it. And now Sodom and Gomorrah has reared its ugly head in great defiance in these last days, as America the Babylon has and is doing. It shows in Isaiah chapter 3 verse 9 what the United States Babylon is doing. Says the show of their countenance does witness against them, and they declare their sin as Sodom, and they hide it not. Woe unto their soul, for they have rewarded evil unto themselves. We see this with all the gay pride and the whoredoms, the transgender story hours, all coming out of the closet, the gay pride, the parades and flags, and all the sin taking place. Sin no longer has any boundaries, even as in Noah's day. Society is collapsing. Truth is not accepted any longer. No two people can see eye to eye. Confusion abounds. It says in the Word that darkness shall cover the earth and gross darkness the people. This is worldwide blindness. This is worldwide deception. This is deception and blindness that was allowed to happen because the Jezebelian religion of Christianity has not and will not teach the real truth. The churches have corrupted this world and made the earth to drink the wine of the wrath of her fornication, the same fornication that is also treason against the truth, Emmanuel and Yah, the same treason that has strengthened the hands of the evildoers, the New World Order, and gave the counterfeit Jews and the world leaders power over us. The blame falls at the feet of the pulpit, and Pastor so-and-so has made sure they have covered over the real truth. They do not want you to know that America is Babylon. If that were so, and if people realize that America is the whore of Babylon, then the prophecies concerning Babylon points directly at us, and Pastor so-and-so knows this. To teach this truth means the church pews go empty and the collection plates are not full. They lose their power base. They know it instinctively, and they will not let this truth come out. Therefore, they have set up the people, the flock, in Jeremiah 23:1, start there, to be destroyed. Yah's going to reward this evil, wicked preacher, as the pastors are acting as prison guards, holding the people in captivity to the lies, to the carnal, know-it-all Christian ego that will not accept truth. America is under judgment. We're all living inside of that judgment, awaiting the day when it's time to exit Babylon, when it's time to escape its all-out destruction. It says in Jeremiah chapter 51, and I'll go over two verses. Verse 57, and I'll make drunk her princes and her wise men, her captains and her rulers and her mighty men. Notice it says her. United States is symbolized by Lady Liberty, right? Jezebel. And they shall sleep a perpetual sleep and not wake, saith the king, whose name is Elohim of hosts. Take a look at all the unwise and the foolish decisions. Destroying the Nord Stream pipeline. Shutting down the Keystone pipeline. Destroying food processing plants. Toxic train derailments. Fertilizer destruction. Provoking nuclear war with Russia. And every insane thing they are doing. Yes, they are drunken all night. And you could say drunken on power at the same time. It all goes hand in hand together. And they shall not awake. So America will not be taken back. They're not going to elect someone in the office to change things. We can't keep doing the same things, expecting different results. That's the definition of insanity, is it not? Doing the same things, expecting different results. Have we ever elected anyone that solved our problems? The answer is absolutely no. Maybe a few times some of the evil was slowed down, but that's as far as it has ever went. And electing Trump, Musk, DeSantis, RFK, or whoever is not going to solve the problem. These are distractions from the horrible destruction that America is going to receive. And it's very clear that the United States had several attempts to assassinate President Putin. Do you not think that Russia is going to respond to this? They're going to respond. They're not a paper tiger. They're just holding out, taking the blows for when the time is right. And believe me, even as the word says, America the Babylon will be judged, and by the time it's all over in the end, there will not be a single inhabitant left in this horrifying, terrible, wicked.
The world being on the precipice of World War III, which will include the United States of America and on our soul, if that, along with America losing its reserve currency status of the world and the petrol dollar going down the tubes, as the BRIC nations continue to
But now notice what is happening with May 12th of 2023, the border invasion. And he said it would happen. And it says here in verse 58, thus saith the Elohim of hosts, the broad walls of Babylon shall be utterly broken, and her high gates shall be burned with fire, and the people shall labor in vain, and the folk meaning nations, for that's a lot of nations coming into this country, right, in the fire, and they shall be weary. The broad walls, the borders have been dissolved, and the borders do not exist anymore. Yeah, the broad walls of Babylon is broken, and her high gates shall be burned with fire. And yeah, are we not laboring in vain? They're coming over here getting free goodies, free debit cards, free phones, free Medicaid, free welfare. What are we getting? We're laboring in vain. They think they're entitled coming into this country, thinking they're just going to call the shots. And they can't even speak English. They rule the whole show. America is under judgment. Soon, lest I be wrong, it's going to be time to escape the land of Babylon. The voice of them that flee and escape Babylon. It is going to happen, people. America will be destroyed. We're being invaded by foreign imperial forces invited by the Barack Obama O'Biden regime. The third term of Barack Obama is now taking its full course. And yet America still sleeps because Pastor So-and-so still has the world convinced that it's Iraq or it's the Catholic Church. Anything other than themselves, they do not want to accept that they are part of the horror of Babylon. If that was the case, then they're required to come out of Vermont, people. Do not partake of her sins, lest you receive also of her plagues. And Pastor So-and-so cannot afford for people to know the truth. They will not accept truth. They'll only teach error, doctrines of devils, and bring people into sorceries, counterfeit works of the Spirit, counterfeit Holy Spirit through Jezebel and Satan's minions, and keep leading the flock straight to the slaughter while the people are unaware of that which they are doing. These are indeed terrifying and sad days. And here it comes. America is under judgment. It will not be restored. It will not be taken back. We will not elect someone in the office to change things. The snowball effect has begun, and it's not going to stop. America will be utterly destroyed. It will not rise up again. But once Yah has started his judgment, he does not stop until it is complete. There's no breaks. It will be complete in full. Rooftop Videos presents the coming destruction of America, the Babylon.
Border with the end of Title 42. Tens of thousands of migrants now getting the green light to cross into the U.S.
An invasion? An understatement. And it's already started. You won't believe the hundreds of Chinese. And who in the heck would give them all free cell phones? You won't believe it. People said it wouldn't happen. It's happening.
Gate 42 is officially open.
On Tuesday, we apprehended over 10,000 people on the border again. The highest level in history. They're encountering 90 to 100 Chinese nationals. Now, for anyone that doesn't have their globe nearby, China is not immediately to the south of the United States. But 90 to 100 a day are crossing illegally on this border, being smuggled in by Mexican drug cartels. And I have to say, I am angry. Because this is deliberate. This is a decision that was made by President Joe Biden and Kamala Harris and congressional Democrats to open up the border to what is nothing less than an invasion.
Indeed, an invasion. Look at this. Thousands and thousands. Like I said, we have people writing in. Publications of over 7 million already that have crossed. Other publications showing that there's 7,000 waiting and more are joining daily. When the word gets out, how many do you think are going to join this movement around the world? You think about all the bad places, ship them to Mexico, they can walk right through.
So ladies and gentlemen, this bus, they have dozens if not hundreds of these buses all throughout El Paso, all throughout Texas, taking illegal immigrants everywhere. And it's more important to protect the illegal immigrants and drive this bus through a ravine across the border so they can get them on without the American media seeing them. And this bus is gonna take them somewhere deep in the heart of Texas, drop them off. But Border Patrol tells us the border's secure, nobody's crossing, nobody's coming in illegally, as it happens right in front of our face. Right in front of our face. Right in front of our face.
Get out of the way, Americans, there's illegals coming in. Get out of the way, Americans, there's illegals coming in. Get out of the way, Americans, there's illegals coming in. Get out of the way, dirty Americans, we got non-citizens we gotta help. Get out of the way, dirty Americans, we got non-citizens we gotta help. Get out of the way, dirty Americans, we got non-citizens we gotta help. You dirty, stinking Americans, this isn't your country. Get out of the way!
Just cue the Imperial March.
Dun, 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 dun.
I can say about that, but 17 kilograms of explosives were intended to kill Vladimir Putin, according to Bild Research, a German news agency. The Ukrainian Secret Service attempted to assassinate Russian President Vladimir Putin with a kamikaze.
I can't predict the future, and I don't have a crystal ball, but the Bible talks about the end times. There's so many prophecies there all throughout the Bible. And they're being fulfilled right before our very eyes. Mm-hmm. Is it going to be World War III? Absolutely. The United States has got to fall. Babylon will fall. Mm-hmm. I'm not trying to tell you what to do or when to do it. But in my opinion, believers, if you haven't left the cities and already have a bug out place to go to, or a place to go to, period, if you haven't cut ties with those cities, you need to. We need to come out of the system totally. You know, you can't hide from the beast. Only God's protection. His hand over us. His feeding us, giving us everything we need. Not going to make it through this great tribulation that's soon to come.
We're going to get into what's going on. We are on the verge of nuclear annihilation. Let's get this straight. Russia accused Ukraine of attempting to assassinate Vladimir Putin in a late-night drone attack on the Kremlin and vowed to retaliate. As we'd say in the Bronx, payback's a bitch. The Kremlin went on to describe, quote, a planned terrorist attack and attempted assassination of the president of Russia, which, quote, reserves the right to take where and when it sees fit. You got it. This thing is ramping up big. If we do not have peace, it's going to be the end of life on Earth. World War II is not ancient history. People better grow up about this. We have maniacal, evil people, mentally deranged, in charge of our lives. And as I say, when all else fails, they take you to war. And I just read it to you, just showed you the facts, the analysis of the socioeconomic decline that we're headed for is going to be the worst in modern history.
All right, so the mushroom cloud that you're seeing behind me here is foreshadowing. This is World War III. This is what it's going to look like. This detonation happened just a few hours ago in the western part of Ukraine. This is an ammunition depot that was taken out, possibly by a Shahed drone by the Russians, maybe a Caliber, maybe a Kinzhal. I don't really know. Regardless, it's a big explosion, and it's foreshadowing, I do believe. I think we're going to see this, but non-conventional, the way things are going, because according to some sources, they're speculating that the Ukrainians might actually try to invade along the eastern Russian front.
There's a secret Fed bailout happening right now, and it's looking like 2008 all over again. Banks are collapsing, executives are taking fat bonuses, and the White House is running to their rescue, while regular people are struggling. Can't pay their bills, they can't fill their tanks with gas. Then suddenly, Biden has the nerve to bail out wealthy Americans again.
One of the phrases I use is, you know, spirituality, true spirituality, comes with a spine. Because true spirituality knows that it's all that is, has been, and ever can be. And no matter what happens here, in this brief experience called human, it will always be all that is, has been, and ever can be. So therefore, the consequences of doing what you know to be right cease to be part of the conversation.
Kyiv is accusing Russia of firebombing the besieged city of Bakhmut using phosphorus munitions. In drone video released by Ukraine, Bakhmut can be seen ablaze as what appears to be phosphorus rains down. And according to Human Rights Watch report, phosphorus can burn through metal. Its use is considered a war crime when deployed against civilians.
Charles will wear St. Edward's crown, decorated with more than 400 gemstones. Camilla, meanwhile, the queen consort, will carry 2,200 diamonds in hers, worth up to an estimated £5 billion.
Well, Doug, it's the most problematic time in the last, I would say, in the last 6 months. Everybody should be now convinced that America is under, and I'm not going to apologize for this, divine judgment, the living God. I'll start with America's insanity has exceeded the speed of light. You know, maybe Einstein, I'm not Einstein, but I'd like to come up with an equation that equals that statement. And maybe it would just be a simple tombstone with the words, America died. Ladies and gentlemen, what's happening is unparalleled, and the silence in the Republicans, the freaking whores, the people you elected, the people I elected, the people we elected, and by the way, I'm very selective in who I even vote for. The bottom line is they have betrayed you unto death.
That the FDIC before today had $125 billion in its rescue fund, okay? And the total deposits in commercial banks across the United States is almost 10 trillion. It's like 9.5 trillion, something in that range. And the FDIC, as you said, has a fraction of a fraction of the funds needed to bail out other banks. The problem is the FDIC essentially just spent maybe most of its money bailing out three banks.
The lie here that Putin false flagged the Kremlin, I believe it's a lie, is just as ridiculous as him saying that Putin blew up the Nord Stream pipeline and all he had to do was turn it off. And all the strategic reasons and all the key bono who benefits goes to the West. We have admissions, threats to blow it up, evidence the West blew it up. Then now they have articles all over the place. This is Politico that, and BBC 2 days ago saying Russia blew up the pipeline with no evidence, and saying Russia's going to blow up more pipelines. Now they could reciprocate and start blowing up Western pipelines and then just say, we don't know who did it. It's like the West did. That could happen.
Well, time to come out of that country, out of that system that believes that. I've been warning people forever that they're coming after our children and all this mutilation of the organs of our children, trans. Now I'm going to bring some fire here. You know, I'm going to preach the truth, and I don't care who doesn't like it. We don't put up with that in the kingdom of Yah. They're serious. And if you still have your children in those so-called public schools, you need to get them out. I've been saying this forever. My children are grown now, but I got 10 grandchildren. Some are in school, some are not. You know, I'm asking you to pray about this seriously. Things are heating up. You know, Klaus Schwab, the WEF, the United Nations, the New World Order, the Great Reset. You know, they all want you, or they will cause you. Not make you, but cause you. And I think mostly because of famine, they will cause you to take the mark of the beast in order to survive. Yeah, but there's another mark, the mark of God sealed in your foreheads, with the name of Yah written in your foreheads. That's the one that you need.
They're here.